Hello everyone, this is Manoj Yadav from Mechanical Engineering Department. In our last lecture, we discussed about the trusses. So, trusses and beams both are the structural members. When we say structural members, we mean to say the members which are used in building work or construction work. Those members are known as structural members. So, today we will learn about beams. So when we talk about beam, first of all, you must know the definition of a beam. A beam can be defined as a structural member which is supported at some points and which bears the load. You must have seen in the buildings that we have the beams. Beams are supported with help of pillars, and the basic purpose of beams is to bear the load. Okay, so this is the general definition of a beam, that a beam is a structural member which is supported at some points and which bears the load. Now, before moving ahead, you must know that what are the various types of supports. So, there are total four types of supports. First one is simple support, then roller support, hinge support and fixed support. These are four types of supports. Now, when we talk about supports, you must be able to identify the support, and you must have the knowledge that when this support will be eliminated and we make the free body diagram of this support, which type of reaction will be there. So a simple support is represented by a single triangle, and when we draw the free body diagram of that support or that triangle, we make one vertical reaction. Similarly, roller support is presented by a triangle with two rollers, and when we draw the free body diagram of roller support, we use again one vertical reaction. Then hinge support or pin support. It is denoted by a triangle with hatching in the lower side, or it is also denoted by a circle with pin point. That's why it is also known as pin joint. So while drawing the free body diagram of the hinge support or pin support, we use one vertical reaction and one horizontal reaction. Okay, keep it in mind that in case of simple support, we draw one vertical reaction. In case of roller support, we use one vertical reaction. And in case of hinge support, we use one vertical reaction and one horizontal reaction. Then last support is fixed support. Suppose a end of a beam is fixed in the wall. So that type of support is known as fixed support. So whenever we have the fixed support, in place of fixed support, we use one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction and one movement, which is known as the fixing movement. Okay, so this is all about the types of supports. Simple support, roller support, hinge support and fixed support. Now, you must be able to know the types of loads. See, the loads are of three types. First one is point load or concentrated load. Second one is uniformly distributed load or UDL. And third one is uniformly varying load or UVL. Okay, so let's see point load. A load which acts at a single point of a beam is known as point load. You can see in the diagram, a beam is given in which at point A we are having simple support, at point B we have roller support, and the load of W kilonewton is acting at half of the length, that is L by 2 from A point and L by 2 from B point. Suppose I ask you to determine the value of support reactions. So first of all, you will have to draw the free body diagram of this beam. You will eliminate all the supports, and in place of support, you will make the reactions. So you can see that at point A, we have simple support. So we will use one vertical reaction, RA. Similarly, at point B, we have roller supports. So we will use one vertical reaction here also, RB. So these are the reactions, RA and RB, and the load acting is W. Now you can see I have drawn the free body diagram of this figure. Now for finding out the value of these reactions, we will use the conditions of equilibrium. First one is sigma fx equal to 0, that is sum of all horizontal forces equal to 0. Now in this diagram you can see that there is no horizontal force, so first condition is already satisfied. Now while making second equation sigma fy equal to 0, sum of all vertical forces equal to 0, we take upward forces as positive and downward forces as negative and make equation equal to 0. So in this diagram we can say Ra plus Rb minus W equal to 0 or Ra plus Rb equal to W. Now third equation is moment equation. So we generally take moment about that point at which we are having the unknown values. You can see in this beam one unknown is at point A, which is Ra, and one unknown is at point B, which is Rb. So either you can take moment about A point or you can take moment about B point. In this figure I have taken the moment about point A. So while taking the moment about point A, the moment of Ra will be 0. Rb will try to rotate the body in anti-clockwise direction, so its moment will be positive, and W will try to rotate the beam in clockwise direction, so its moment will be negative. So equation will be Rb into L minus W into L by 2 equal to 0. So Ra plus Rb equal Rb equal to W by 2, and similarly Ra will also be equal to 1 W by 2. So in this way we can find out the value of reactions in case of point load. Now we have the second load, which is UDL, a load which is uniformly distributed over entire length of beam, that is known as UDL or uniformly distributed load, and it is denoted either by arrows in a rectangle or by a spring. Okay, so while drawing the free body diagram of UDL, we will have to convert this UDL into point load first. So in case of UDL, total load is taken as intensity into length. Here intensity is W kilonewton per meter and length is L. So in this case, when we will convert this UDL into point load, the total load will be W into L, and load acts at half of the distance. So this W into L will act at L by 2 from A and L by 2 from B. Now again by making equations sigma fx 0, sigma fy equal to 0 and sigma m equal to 0, we can find out the value of reactions. So Ra plus Rb minus WL equal to 0, then take moment about A point, so Rb into L minus WL into L by 2 equal to 0, so Rb equal to WL by 2 and Ra will also be equal to WL by 2. In this way we can find out the value of reactions in case of UDL. Now we have the third type of load, which is called uniformly varying load. If the load varies uniformly with length, this is called uniformly varying load or a triangular load. So in case of triangular load, total load is equal to 1 by 2 base into height, that is 1 by 2 W into L. This is the total load. See, in case of UDL, total load was intensity into length, W into L, while in case of UVL, the total load is 1 by 2 W into L. And this total load will act at 2/3 from the vertex. You can see in the diagram that vertex is at point A. So when we convert this UDL into point load, this point load of WL by 2 will act at 2/3 of L from point A. Then again this problem is converted into previous problem, and we will use conditions of equilibrium for solving Ra and Rb. So Ra plus Rb minus WL by 2 equal to 0, Ra plus Rb equal to WL by 2. Again take moment about point A, so Rb into L minus WL by 2 into 2L by 3 equal to 0. So in this way we can calculate the value of Rb, which is WL by 3. Now put this WL by 3 in first equation, you will get Ra equal to WL by 6. So in this way we can find out the value of reactions Ra and Rb in case of UDL or UVL or point load. So these are various types of loads. point load, UDL and UVL. You can summarize that in case of UDL, total load is equal to intensity into length, W into L, and it acts at half of the length. While in case of UVL, total load is equal to 1 by 2 W into L, and it will act at 2/3 of length from the vertex. So this is all about types of loads. Now we will see the various types of beams. So we have generally five types of beams. First one is simply supported beam. You can see in the diagram, a beam which is having the supports at the end points, that type of beam is known as simply supported beam. Now the supports may be either of simple support or roller support or hinge support, but whatever the support may be, it will be at the end of the beam. So this is called simply supported beam, a beam which is having the support at the end points. Then second one is cantilever beam, a beam which is fixed at one end and free at the other end is known as cantilever beam. You can see in the diagram, we have a beam which is fixed at one side. So when we draw the free body diagram of this beam, we will take one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, and one moment at this end, and at the other end there is no support, so this end is known as free end. So we have two ends, one is free end and another one is fixed end. So this type of beam is called cantilever beam. You can see the examples in real life. The porch is example of cantilever. In porch, one end of the beam is fixed and other side is free, it is having no support. Or the branches of trees, they are also the example of this cantilever beam. Then we have third type of beam, which is called fixed beam. If both ends of the beam are made fixed, then this type of beam is called fixed beam. So while drawing the free body diagram of a beam, you will get one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, and one moment at point A. Similarly, one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, and one moment at point B. So when we make both ends fixed, this type of beam is called fixed beam. Now fourth beam is continuous beam. A beam which is having more than two supports is known as a continuous beam. Simple example of continuous beam you can see in the bridges which are made over the rivers. So only they are not having only two supports, a lot of support, a lot of pillars are there. So that type of beam is known as a continuous beam. Then fifth type of beam is overhanging beam, a beam in which some length of beam hangs beyond the supports is called overhanging beam. You can see in the diagram that beyond the support we have some length of beam hanging there. So it may hang either on one side or on both sides. So on basis of that, overhanging beam may be of two types, one side overhanging and both side overhanging. Now beyond these five types of beams, we also have two other types of beam which are known as determinate beam and indeterminate beam. Now what is determinate beam? A beam in which value of reactions can be determined by using conditions of equilibrium, sigma fx equal to 0, sigma fy equal to 0, and sigma m equal to 0 is called a determinate beam. So if we are able to find out the value of reactions by using these three conditions of equilibrium, then those types of beams are known as determinate beams. So a simply supported beam, a cantilever beam, and overhanging beam, all these types of beams are determinate beams because we can find out the reactions easily. Seventh type of beam is indeterminate beam. Now if the value of reactions cannot be determined with help of three conditions of equilibrium, sigma fx 0, sigma fy 0 and sigma m equal to 0, then these types of beams are known as indeterminate beam. So in indeterminate beams, the value of unknowns is more than 3. We have only 3 conditions of equilibrium to solve the equation, but the unknowns are 4 or 5 or 6. Then we will not be able to find out the value of reactions. So those types of beams are known as indeterminate beam. So the examples of indeterminate beams are continuous beam and fixed beam. You can see in fixed beam, we are having total 6 unknowns, one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, one moment at one end, and one vertical reaction, one horizontal reaction, one moment at other end. So total 3 and 3, 6 unknowns are there, and we are only have 3 conditions of equilibrium to solve these equations. So the value of reactions cannot be determined. So these types of beams are known as indeterminate beam. So this is all about the theory of beams. In our next lecture, we will see how to determine the shear force and bending moment and how to draw the SFD and BMD of various beams. Okay, thank you everyone.